scare up that alchemist? What needed finding? What's it gonna be this time? Time for another break, anyways.
Here we go! I can't believe we're gonna see the giants!
Well, if things worked according to plan... Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
Let's hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure you'll be fine. Ready?
Oh, that's unpleasant!
Now, boy!
Well, what are we waiting for? Think it's far?
We will see.
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Oh, fine, damn it. Fine!
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.
Boy, do I have plans for you.
Do you hurry back, please?
Don't flatter yourself.
Giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy. Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now.
Hello? Anybody here?
This place.
They must have all come through here when they left Midgard. What was left of them.
Why carve all these faces?
What if this is all the giants that got out of Midgard alive? Not really many at all. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody.
Where are they now?
The giants came back home so they could survive. But I'm not sure they did. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to them? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
It's your axe. It's Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Her mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
No. We do it together. Son.
There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. Giants called me Loki?
Loki? That is the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Hey, check this out. Over here.
Guess it all makes sense now. Why she want to end up here? Be with her kind? But did she know it was going to be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people? Or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. Why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope that though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow, you actually told a good story. We near missed it.
I understand if you want to go home, but I bet there are still some corrupted Valkyries out there that could be set free. Some other help people need. Maybe helping people is part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Am I glad to see you? I believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else?
Thank you.
Before we return to Midgard, I should warn you. More time has passed than you likely realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur has become something else. The stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter, but a great winter to span three summers. And when it's done,
Ragnarok.
Aye, snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world, in that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something. Prophecy didn't count on you.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbul Winter. I can feel it in my throat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end times.
How dare you make any voices?
Guys?
Just discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is, Fimbul Winter's upon us, boys. The winner to end all winners. I can feel it in my throat.
Yeah, we heard.
So if you're heading home, try to keep moving, and also to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Oh, I quite agree. Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
We're finally home. Feels like a lifetime ago.
Bit drafty, maybe. It's a right improvement over having tree bark in your tadger.
Time to rest.
I'm gonna sleep through winter.
Okay, this'll do.
Sleep.
Way ahead of you.
Atreus, are you ready?
Yeah, but I had the weirdest dream. Fimbulwinter was ending, and Thor came for us, here at the house.
It was only a dream.
But it felt different. It felt real. It felt like the future.
Then we will worry about it tomorrow. Today, there are still things we can do. Come. We are done here.
Thank you.
was next to Mother's garden this whole time. No wonder we can never get in there. Desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway.
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all, and it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
why do they call Odin the Lord of the Hang?
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. Aye, hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think, quite rightly, it got fed up with him and sent him back to the land of the living. Did I not mention he was barking mad?
Figure out. Odin wants to prevent Ragnarok, but the Serpent's already been there and seen it. So hasn't he already failed?
Fate's a tricky thing, lad. And Odin's just arrogant enough to think he can get the best of it.
Fate is another lie told by the gods. Nothing is written that cannot be unwritten.
On that, brother, you and the Allfather may just agree. Even if he can't prevent Ragnarok, he still hopes to learn enough details to influence the outcome. Remind me later to tell you about the wolves.
Is it a good idea coming back here?
She's probably in there planning your demise, brother.
Or bringing Baldur back to life. Like she did you, Mimir.
Oh, I'm not alive, lad. I'm reanimated, sure. But make no mistake, I'm still quite dead. I'll never be what I once was. She won't want this for her son. Trust me.
That's a relief. Not the part about you being dead, but... you know.
Atreus, follow me.
A Valkyrie. We have to save her.
Think before you act. Are we prepared to face such a powerful foe?
I'm ready if you are.
Aye, same here. If that counts for anything.